There was one time, Rich, and you know, Warren, the one thing people don't know, he was a tremendous teammate and he worked his tail off. You know, every practice, this guy competed his tail off. You know, but there was one period of time where Warren was acting up a little, and usually a combination of Brooks and I, or Brooks or myself, could get to Warren and say, "Hey, let's calm down, big man. Let's think about the team and let's think about this." And there was this one time where we threw our hands up and we said, "Coach, you know, we can't." And we went in Coach Dungy's office and said, "We can't do anything. You know, he's acting up, and I think you have to sit him." And Coach looked at us calmly, like Tony does. He took a deep breath and he said, "You guys, I'll never forget it. He said, you guys, in my mind, are both Hall of Fame players. But John, I can play without you. Derek, I can play without you. We can't play without 99. So you best figure it out." So Derek and I walked out defeated and said, "All right, we got to figure it out."
I do remember that. Because a matter of fact, Rich McKay was in Tony's office talking to him about, man, you know, the same thing. Like, what if you have to discipline one? What are you going to do? Wait, and we interrupt that conversation like, "Hey, look," I said, "Coach, I don't know what's going on with it. Maybe it's personal." I said, "Maybe the only thing, you know, get his attention if you don't play him or sit him." Man, Coach looked up and said that. He said, "Hey, play without you, Rich, Derek, it'll be tough, but yeah, 99 ain't no way. Not any way." So he said, "So I suggest you, if it takes all night, you guys better find a way." He said, "You better find a way."
Wow. We got it done. He was good the next day.
So Warren comes in the next day, man. I didn't practice all this stuff I'm getting ready to say to him, like, "Okay, this is going to work. That's not going to work." I've been talking to myself in the mirror. He comes in the next day, Rich, like nothing happened. Like, I'm like, it was so like, "Hey, what's up, fellas? What's going on? Let's better go to work."
I have no idea what any of y'all just said. I'm glad my headset just cut off. I hope it was good. I heard none of that.
Can you hear us right now, Warren?
No, I was joking the whole time, Rich. I heard every word. I'm gonna kill him. I'm gonna kill him.
Did you know that story from Dougie? You knew that?
Listen, no, man, but you know, listen, Rich, you worked with me for 7 years. Sounds like a bad cold. Just sometimes you just gotta let him run his course. I'll come back. I'll come back. I'm coming back to the reservation. I'm coming back.
Honestly, did you just hear that story for the first time?
Yes.
I never told you.
But it doesn't matter. I came in the next day with a clean slate, man. You can't bring yesterday into the day, Rich. My mother told me and my grandma told me, you're not promised tomorrow. So if you wake up, that's why I normally started off with good morning. So at least you got a good morning out of me. So here we go. And I'll tell you where it might go from there.
That is amazing. I mean, the story. Oh,
I thought he knew that one. I did not know. No, he did not know that.
No.
I never told him.
No. You don't want to break up old stuff with me. Just leave it. Let it lie. Let it lie. Like I'm an elephant. I hold grudges. Don't do that.
You don't forget a thing either.
Hey, I hold grudges. If you make me remember it, I hold grudges. I had to speak to Keyshawn this morning on his little radio show. He asked me for a FaceTime. I'm like, what happened to your Zoom, son? What y'all over there collecting data or something? You ain't getting my FaceTime, you know? So I'm back on the phone, and you know, I say, you know what? I'm going to do it like Brooks told me. Just make it good. Just stop right there. I stopped this morning.
Man, well.
I was that close.
This is phenomenal. That is amazing that I've never heard that story either, obviously.
I'm glad I would have told it.
Well, Dungy had your back, Warren. I mean, you know.
Listen, man. Me and Dungy had a special, special relationship. The man used to keep my daughter on Friday night so I can take the wife out on date night. So just trust me. It's an Avila thing. I'm just glad he understood me. I guess when you play with Joe Green used to do a lot worse than that, man.
That is amazing. Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.